the city of Monterey. Its economy flourishes in tourism year-round. Historically, the city of Monterey yields a rich background of historic events, from the first European explorer to the heyday of the fishing industry to the preservation of aquatic animal life. The city of Monterey continues to be a place of history and natural splendor. This is Asilomar State Beach, and this is where our story begins. This is Asilomar III, and as you can see, this is the Pacific Coast. I'm Eliren Pasion, you know, the guy with the silly string. Well, this is my segment for the cast party, and it's called Asilomar III, One Step Ahead in Trouble. What you're going to see is a couple of segments that I happen to get by accident, and raw accident, being redundant here. But what we're going to see now is a couple of segments from the past Asilomar ones and the most recent ones. So right now, let's roll that tape, shall we? Okay, Asilomar 1986. Well, what I have here is a bunch of still photos. So, here's a shot of the front door, a couple of people walking in. Ah, what a majestic entrance, isn't it? Ooh, I can see the excitement building now. Okay, here's another photo of the gang. Oh, you can see Jim Delaria. And hey, look, the guy in the lifeguard shirt. Yes, that's a thinner Chris Wilkinson. You'll be surprised what I got of him next. And the next photo I have here, next photo, please. There we go. Next photo is out-of-focus shot of the guys playing hacky sack. I don't know if they still do that anymore. Anyways, this is a shot of, Leanne Stainer and the girl next to her. That's Jill Zolkis, believe it or not. Shorter hair, wow. Dan Lund, wow, where have those people gone to? Who knows? Anyways, that's a party they held in Doug's place when they had a kitchenette, where they actually trusted him. Okay, next photo, believe it or not, that's Chris Wilkinson, yeah. Yeah, he still has the same beard. He doesn't have the mustache, though. Next photo we have is, look, this is Doug Prazak, when he had a lot more hair. Well, I won't say that. At least his hair looked normal. Natural, at least. And enthused Bob Docterman at the Ohlone table. And, one of the more nutritious meals. I don't know what this is, so that looks already tasteful, or tasteless in this case. Okay, let's go a year later to Asilomar 2, and this time our group was a little bit prepared. At least Doug didn't know about this.
This is our fearless leader.
Who's he?
He's never here.
This is our fearless leader,
Doug
Prazak.
That's our executive producer, Doug Prazak.
Doug Prazak.
What is that?
Is this a bad place to put the mic?
Clap over your head. Clap over your head. Clap, 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 clap.
Evans, what are you doing here in the Ohlone College / NCTV production group?
I'm a producer.
And what did you produce?
According to Tim Solero, a piece of crap.
Well, I wouldn't say that. At least you gave it a shot. However, their stories were as diverse as a bowl of nuts.
Faraway ports include Melbourne, Australia, and Kansas City, Missouri.
I'm Jim Delaria, reporting here at Asilomar State Beach, where I'm talking with Ranger Dave Nixon. How about a little bit of history about the sand dunes here at Asilomar?
Yeah, the Asilomar sand dunes are a unique example of natural sand dunes in Monterey Peninsula.
The famed 17-mile drive. For a small fee, tourists can drive their vehicles through this scenic Pebble Beach area and gawk at the secluded homes of the rich and famous.
Thanks, Jim. And gawk they did, for Angela Thomas's group went in there and they basically made a mockery of the place.
17 miles in Monterey, and you have a blast, but the only problem is it costs $5 to get in. Any of you guys got $5?
$5 for the drive.
It's me again. We're here at Point Joe. Right here, boy. This is called the Ghost Tree. It's item number 20 on your 17-mile drive. And what an item it is, too. Whew. Robert Louis Stevenson used to think this was like, you know, a ghost. So that's why he called it the Ghost Tree. And the name stuck. And people like us come by, tour, look stupid, and make fools of ourselves.
So how do you enjoy the Monterey Bay coast?
It's beautiful, but it's about 60 miles south of here.
At Asilomar 3, the students came back once again to learn about ENG. What happened back there? I saw something happen to the box. It looked like it hit the ground. What happened to the box?
Cheap box.
Cheap box. Take a look at the box.
Right over there. See? Had it with one hand and it just broke.
Just broke.
You know what I mean? These cheap Miller people. What can you say? They're just not like they used to be.
Not. Hey, Edwards! Edwards! Where the hell are you, Mike? You've got my camera! Mike! Mike! Whoa! 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 Ah! Ah! There you are. Oh, well, I hope everybody's enjoying their meal. I heard Holly put arsenic in the main course, so you guys should be feeling real good after a while. Let's see, our next segment at Asilomar 3, let's see, what do we have on our list? Let's play the famed Solero Edwards shooting, shall we? Now, this little segment will go down in Asilomar history, so let's roll tape. We were only there for a matter of hours before the first accident happened. Watch very closely. This takes only a second.
Oh, sorry, Tim. I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Tim. I'm really sorry. Shit. Where did you hit him? Where did he hit him?
Student hit. Student hit.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to hit you there. I'm sorry. I'm really sorry.
You're drunk.
Solero, is my balcony open?
Yeah.
Is it okay?
Yeah, it's all right. Don't move. Sorry about that. Tim, I got excited and I shot. I'm sorry. Tim! My God, Tim! Shit, I feel stupid. It was a good shot.
What does it
Mike?
Look like?
What?
What does Mike? It look like?
Mike?
What?
That way.
I felt stupid. Shit.
Passion. Is he okay?
I think so.
Later that evening, Chris Wilkinson and a number of students publicly humiliated Michael Edwards.
Got that?
Go.
Okay.
So early Monday morning, our eager students gathered in the curlew. They packed their gear.
That camera sucks.
Yeah. The
and got final instructions from Doug.
Okay, have fun. Be back as soon as you can. Okay. See you guys and start it. You'll be the first group editing.
And they were off.
Well, about 20 songs on this one.
Uh-huh. Once they came back from shooting, each group quickly assembled their stories together. However, Tim Solero and Chris Wilkinson were working on their segment for Pledge Break.
Show you're watching now. Join the family. Join the fun. Your bucks can make us number one. KOHL TV. And now for Cherie Tedson.
Hi.
And Heidi Burnworth.
You're stupid.
And this is the handsome, the lovely, the seldom disgruntled Jill Zolkus.
Hi. What's up? What are you guys doing? That light is so bright.
And they couldn't leave Angela Thomas alone while she took a short nap.
Angela, we're doing a show.
I want to do a show right now.
Why not? Are you dreaming of Michael Del Valle?
No.
No? Angela?
Shanling.
Gary Shanling, why?
Because he's a muffin.
He's got big lips.
No. like big lips.
But you know, TV adds 3 to 5 pounds to your lips.
I can't. And your butt.
She has a fine butt, doesn't she? And Michael Del Val, come back into the picture. This is Michael Del Val, co-host, anchor, whatever, jack of all trades for Newsline. Say something.
Why are you wearing sunglasses, Tim?
Because I'm Corey Hart.
So we're not professionals yet. Okay, what we're going to do now is we're going to show you a short rapid-fire montage of the four groups at Asilomar III and what they did. So if we roll that tape, okay, here we go.
Colton Hall. Although this building wouldn't attract much attention architecturally in comparison to the many historical buildings in the United States, in California, it is without a rival.
Donna Penwell, the manager of the museum, filled us in on the history of Colton Hall.
On October 13, 1849, 48 men sat in this room and signed California's first constitution.
The cannery where we see today grew out of a fascinating past. This bright, colorful street is what remains of lifestyles that grew up and around the catching and canning of the sardines. Along Cannery Row, you'll be sightseeing in the present while holding fast to the past.
Did you know whales have fingers? They have small hip bones and a hidden set of fingers in their fins, remnants from their land-dwelling ancestors 50 to 60 million years ago. And to keep their bones strong and healthy, baby blue whales drink up to 130 gallons of milk a day. This causes them to put on a lot of weight very quickly.
What you see behind me is the equivalent of the blue whale's daily diet. 8,000 Big Macs or 3 million calories. For Ohlone College Newsline, I'm Cherie Stevens.
She wore blue velvet, bluer than velvet was the night, softer than satin was the light from the stars.
When were these buildings built?
Most of them were built in the 1830s and 1840s. And Larkin House was built in 1835, and the Casa Sobranes in 1840, Custom House in 1827. So right around that era was when the adobes were built in this area, in Monterey.
The adobe buildings cost $1 to tour, and they serve as a good starting point for your visit here to the Monterey Bay area. After all, these were the first buildings to be built here. And by the way, this structure, the Larkin House, cost $5,000 to build and furnish when it was built. Today, it's worth over $9 million. For Newsline, I'm Michael Del Val.
And I still can see blue velvet through my teeth. Blue
Okay, so you saw that segment. Now, what do we have next? Oh, here's some more footage that a number of the students shot. It was shot with Mike Edwards' bum cam, and the people doing camera is one of three people. It could be Chris Wilkinson, it could be Mike Edwards, it could be Angela Thomas, who knows? But let's take a look, shall we?
Chris walked around asking everybody this question.
What?
You just finished editing a killer video. Where are you gonna go now? Disneyland? You're in your second night of heavy-duty video ENG workshopping.
Yeah.
Where are you going to go now? Disneyland?
No, I got to get ready for pledge break.
That's what Angela said. I don't believe this is happening.
$7. And let me tell you, it was worth it, okay?
Is that all you get is a wine cooler, though?
Hi. Wine cooler. Six, seven.
You got my raise when we did Sleuth.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Call again. I'm the personal tour guide here at Asilomar this weekend. Follow me. Let's go see if we can sell something else to tag.
a beautiful day to get a suntan out here, right? Sure. And I'm in an Eskimo parka. All right. The next segment we'll show is, I don't know, we'll have something on tape. Maybe you guys will enjoy it, maybe not. Hope you guys don't have too much to eat, because you may not be able to get home. But don't forget, we've got to go bowling tonight. All right, let's roll that tape. Roll tape! Yeah, sure.
Stew. You know, the bitch about this is I'm eating with a fork, so all the stew part runs through. I'm left with this mysterious meat.
I'm wearing my Asilomar hat today. You know, this is the final game of the Ohlone College Television Spring 88 home season. And it's funny that I'm wearing my Asilomar hat, and I got a cigar tonight. I mean, it's pretty weird, isn't it, Eller? Ostrowski, give me a light, man.
The most thing I remember about Asilomar, well, actually, I really wasn't there, so I really don't know, Eller.
Most memorable thing about my trip to Asilomar...
How about that lunch at the beginning?
Was CNN Monterey. Just walking into my room with my roommate, you. Just $8,000 worth of cameras and equipment and all kinds of fun stuff.
I was sick the entire time.
Well, tell me about your sickness.
I made the mistake of drinking alcohol and taking cough medicine, and it was ugly.
The most memorable event was definitely the silly string. I don't know. Oh, Eliren J. Pasion jumping on my balcony and hiding in my shower was probably.
And he says, "Don't worry, you guys. I'm a gymnast."
He hid in our shower.
Does his stretches. Yeah. What else did?
That was
what
probably
else?
The most memorable.
Oh, and then Heidi thought that everyone was on the roof, and Heidi had her ponytail over here to the side. She sat up and said, "No way."
Well, that's because they were jumping on everything else. I mean jumping on everything else.
Yep.
A lot of jumping going on.
Tim.
There's a long drive. Way back. It's going.
Oh, sorry, Tim. I'm sorry, Tim. I'm really sorry.
What do you want me to say?
I'm short. I'm about 5'5" and a half. I weigh somewhere between 128 and 131. It depends on the time of the day and how much
tacos. Yeah, leave the door cracked open so that you can come back.
And well, I've been turned down by literally every woman in America.
Okay, come on.
Except for Tony.
Can I use a lavalier mic?
Tell me about your career. What do you want to do in life?
I want to be a bum.
Sorry, really sorry.
Well, originally I got into Ohlone College radio broadcasting thinking I wanted to be Bob Costas too. This time it's personal. But then, now, I just want to be in radio or TV anywhere. You know, DJ or program or, you know, act. I can do Michael J. Fox's job. All he does is say, "Shut up, Mallory." I can do that.
Well, what do you want to know?
Me, you lousy bitch. Are we in Monterey Bay?
No, not, I don't think so. We're at Half Moon Bay.
I think we're a little lost here. Well, I hope you guys like the project. I hope you're not too bloated with food and wine. I know you're having a lot of fun there in merriment. Look at me. I'm going to be sitting in a boring council meeting. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed my segment of the cast party deal. It was a lot of fun. I hope you enjoyed it all. I hope you're not too bloated with all that food. I know I'm going that way, Mike.
Hey, you're sitting national number one, baby. World Series.
I see you.
Obnoxious, aren't they? Anyways, this is my ending part of the package here. I hope everybody liked it, and hope you all have fun. Well, you know, it was all fun, and hopefully they'll have an Asilomar 4 next year. I hope you all are having a great time and having yourselves stuffed with food and merriment and wine. Hopefully next year we'll have a lot more fun, maybe if there is a next year. Anyways, for Eliren J. Pasion, I'm Eliren J. Pasion. For Mike Edwards, he's Mike Edwards, and that'll do it for this evening. Bye.
Morning.